So over here we have this question on vectors. It says the vector v has this, you can see it is bold. That is always the case with vectors, they always bold them. Has a magnitude of 39. Magnitude means the length. So this whole line, if I were to write it in maths, I'll simply write v in these lines is 39. That means the magnitude of v is 39. And in the same direction as this, when we say it's in the same direction, we basically say that v is parallel to this vector minus 12 and 5. That's what it means. कि वो दोनों एक दूसरे के parallel. Parallel का फायदा क्या होता है कि आप ये कह सकते हो कि v equals some number, let's suppose k है, k times this other vector. So v is a vector. This is k times the other vector because they're parallel. That's what parallel vectors are. And we also know that v का magnitude is 39. So we can simply make it minus 12k and 5k as the new vector v. तो कह रहा है कि find v in terms of a and b. तो अभी पहले हमें k की value निकालते हैं. तो उसके लिए हम देख लेते हैं कि अच्छा इस vector की क्या length है. तो इस vector की length है minus 12 squared plus 5 squared is equal to इसको जब हम solve करेंगे तो हमारे पास final answer 13 आ जाएगा. इसकी मतलब है कि इस वेक्टर की लेंथ है 13, तो 13 को किससे मल्टीप्लाई करूंगे 39 आ जाए 3 से. ठीक है, तो इसका मतलब है k is 3. So k is equal to 13 over 3. K is 3. That means my vector v is 3 times minus 12, जो कि minus 36 बनता है, and 3 times 5, which is plus 15. And there you go. If you don't like that, one other method that you could have done is कि आप यहां से ये वेक्टर निकाल के इस वेक्टर का मैग्नीट्यूड निकालो, बिकॉज़ आपको पता है कि v's मैग्नीट्यूड इज 39. यू कैन सिंपली बी लाइक ओके माइनस 12k होल स्क्वायर्ड प्लस 5k होल स्क्वायर्ड, द होल स्क्वायर रूट इज इक्वल टू 39, एंड दैट विल गिव यू 13k इक्वल्स टू 39 एंड k इज इक्वल टू 3. यहां से आ जाएगा, एंड दैट वे यू कैन आल्सो से दैट वेक्टर v इज 3 टाइम्स माइनस 12 व्हिच इज माइनस 36 एंड 3 टाइम्स 15 व्हिच इज 45. Sorry, 3 times 5, which is 15. And that way you will be able to find out the vector. Next is saying vectors P and Q are such that P is this and Q is this, okay? Given that 2P plus 3Q is 0, 0, find the value of R and S. So it's a pretty simple question. You have to just substitute them. So 2 times P, P is R plus S and R plus 6 plus 3. P times Q, which is 5R plus 1 and 2S minus 1 is equal to 0 and 0. So, we have two simultaneous equations. First equation will be 2R plus 2S plus 15R plus 3. And the second equation will be 2R plus 12 plus 6S minus 3. And this whole thing will be equal to 0, 0, which we can solve simultaneously now. We can break down this. We can say that the first one, which is now 17R plus 2S plus 3 is equal to 0. And second one, we can say, so let it be our first equation. And second one, I'll just write it here. So it's going to be 2R plus 6S plus 9 is equal to 0. And now we have two equations. You can solve them simultaneously, and that will give you the value of R and value of S. Okay, so I guess everybody will be able to do that. We don't need to go through it. All right.
Yes, sir.
Okay, great. Yeah, so let's see if there is any other question in this paper. Nope. So we've done the rest of it. This was November 18. Let's move on to November 19. This is summer 19. So let's see if there is any paper in this vector question. Saif and Sabki recordings are on Google Classroom, so you can just contact them there, see them there, okay? In case you have wanted. All right, so let's do with this one. They're saying find the unit vector in the direction of this. So unit vector kya hota tha? Unit vector is basically, let's suppose a vector u, usko main vector keh deta hun. So unit vector is basically the vector u divided by its magnitude. Isse mujhe kya pata lagta hai? Isse mujhe sirf u ki direction pata chalti hai. Why do I know that? Because every vector can be broken down into its magnitude and its direction. So ye hame direction batata hai aur ye hame uska magnitude batata hai, and through this equation I can basically find out any unit vector that I want. तो पहले मैं इसका मैग्नीट्यूड निकाल लेता हूँ. तो इसका मैग्नीट्यूड होगा 5 स्क्वायर्ड विच इज 25 माइनस प्लस माइनस 15 स्क्वायर्ड एंड दैट विल बेसिकली मेक इट 250 आई थिंक स्क्वायर रूट 250. सो दैट्स द मैग्नीट्यूड. आई डोंट हैव अ कैलकुलेटर सो यू गाइस कैन कंफर्म दिस. एंड वंस आई हैव द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑल आई हैव टू डू इज डिवाइड द वेक्टर 5i माइनस 15j बाय दिस नंबर स्क्वायर रूट 250. So my final vector will become 5 over square root 250, whatever the simplified version is I, minus 15 over square root 250, whatever the simplified version is in J. Okay, so that's how you find unit vector. You just have to understand that any vector can be broken down into its length and its direction. All right, the positive vectors points, vectors of points A and B related to a region are this. So vectors of points ka matlab kya hai? They're basically the position vector of that thing. So OA wo keh raha hai is 3 minus 5 and OB is 12, 7. That's what the term means, that position vectors of this all that. The point C lies on AB. So agar aapke paas ye A hai aur ye B hai, to yahan pe beech mein kahin pe C hai, in which case A to C is 2:1, so that means it's 1/3 the way from B towards A. So yahan pe C hoga aapke paas. So ye 2:1 hai iska. Ratio ye hai, length ye nahi hai. All right, find the position vector of C relative to O. So they're basically saying find OC. OC chahiye aapko. So OC, let's suppose O kahin pe bhi hai. Ye O hai. So mujhe agar O se C jana hai, to I can simply be like, okay, I can go directly from O to C. Or I can go indirectly from O to C, that first I go to O to A and then I go to C. So that's my indirect method. And vectors are all about finding indirect ways to any points that you want. So agar mujhe OC karna hai, I can simply be like that OC can be O to A plus A to C. And O to A, I already know, that is 3 minus 5. And what is A to C? A to C is 2 by 3 because 2/3 the way from A to B. And here I'll apply the idea that position vectors can be converted to other ones. Ke AB ka matlab hoga OB ka vector minus OA ka vector. Remember this. This comes first and this comes after. Toh humare paas koi bhi vector breakdown kiya ja sakta hai in its position vector. And that's what we have done. All we have to do now is plug in the value. So 3 minus 5 plus 2 by 5 or 2 by 3, sorry.
Shouldn't be 2 by 5. Why is it 5? Yeah.
That should be 2 by 3. OB, which is 12, 7, minus OA, which is 3 minus 5. Make sure you don't multiply 2 by 3 with just the first one. You have to make sure you go all the way. So I can simply add it all up. So this will be 3 plus 2 times 12 is 24. Sorry, 2 by 3 times 12 is 8, minus 2 by 3 times minus 3 is minus 2. Similarly, this one is going to be minus 5. Plus 2 by 3 times 7 is 14 by 3. And that multiplied by minus minus 5 is going to be plus 10 by 3. So, jo bhi iska answer aayega, that's my final answer. That's my vector OC. Okay, so, isko aap kar lenge. This will be 9 and this will be 3. Okay, so we have found the position vector of C. Now they're saying point D lies on OB. So wahi diagram agar hum yahan pe dekhen, to yahan par hamare paas ye diagram, I'll just copy this one. So ye hamare paas diagram hai. And point D lies on OB. So O to B, if we connect that, then there's a point D somewhere there. And we know that D, let's suppose yahan pe D kar dete hain. D to C, this vector is 6, 1.25. और हमें ये नहीं पता है कि ओ बी का और ओ डी का क्या रिलेशन है, एक्सेप्ट वी नो दैट द रेशियो इज 1 to λ. ओके, सो दैट्स नो प्रॉब्लम. इफ दिस इज 1, दिस होल थिंग इज लैम्डा, दैट्स द रिलेशन बेसिकली. सो हम उसको देख लेते हैं, दैट ओ डी इज 1 by λ ओ बी. वी ऑलरेडी हैव OB is 12, 7. So it's going to be 1 by lambda 12 sim. Now we already have OC from the previous part, which is 9.3. Now, if somebody messes this one up, then they won't lose marks in the part two. If you didn't get the right answer in C part, sorry, the first part, it won't affect your result in the second one. Just make sure you use the value that you have calculated, regardless of whether it's right or wrong. So, वो कहते हैं कि DC is 6.2.25. लेकिन हमें ये भी पता है कि DC is OC minus OD. So I'll just plug that in there, right? So OC is given to me 9.3. OD I have just figured out is 1 by lambda 12.7. So I can just have two equations and I can just use to compare them with each other. So on the left side, I have 6.1.25. On the right side, I'll have 9 minus 12 by lambda and 3 minus 7 by lambda. In dono ko aap ek ko bhi solve kar loge, aapko answer mil jayega. So if I do this, that 6 equals to 9 minus 12 by lambda, then I'm getting minus 3 is equal to minus 12 by lambda. So lambda is going to be 4. Right? If I try to do it with the other one, I should get the same answer. Let's see if we do that or not. So mere paas ye ban jayega minus 1.75 is equal to minus 7 over lambda. And that is, yeah, that is the same 4. ठीक है, so I've got my answer. Lambda is 4. So ये हमें चाहिए था और वो निकाल लिया. And yeah, that's it. The only question on vectors in this paper. Let's move on to the previous one. Okay, interestingly, the only question on vectors here is on velocity vectors, which are in our syllabus. Let's see this paper. Okay, let's try to do this question. I'm not sure if this just vector relative velocity. Let's see. First says a particle A travels with the speed of this in the direction this. Find the velocity of A. So basically, वो हमसे velocity vector मांग रहा है और उस vector की उसने दो बातें बताई हैं उसने. एक हमें किसी भी vector का magnitude चाहिए होता है और हमें उसकी direction चाहिए होती है. ठीक है. अब direction उसकी इस vector वाली direction है. और मैग्नीट्यूड 6.5 है, तो मैग्नीट्यूड तो उसने दे दिया, डायरेक्शन हमें निकालनी पड़ेगी, तो हम इसका यूनिट वेक्टर निकाल लेते हैं. लेट मी कॉल दिस यू, दिस इज माय वी ए. सो यू का यूनिट वेक्टर क्या होगा? माइनस 5 आई माइनस 12 जे ओवर देयर मैग्नीट्यूड, एंड दिस इज एक्चुअली द सेम वैल्यू एज द प्रीवियस वन, सो इसका मैग्नीट्यूड 13 आएगा. तो मेरे पास बन जाएगा माइनस 5 ओवर 13 आई माइनस 12 ओवर 13 जे. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू गो थ्रू इट, यू कैन सिंपली डू Pythagoras theorem, minus 5 squared plus minus 12 squared giving you 13. So ye yahan pe humne divide kar diya. So that means that's my unit vector. So hamare paas ye ban jayega minus 5 over 13 I or minus 12 over 13 J. This I can simplify as 6.5 divided by 13 is 0.5. Is it? Yeah, it is. So that means it's going to be minus 2.5 I or ye ban jayega minus 6 J. Achha, yahan pe ek cheez dhyan mein rakhein ki when you are, there are multiple ways of writing vectors. One vector is ki aap isko, let's suppose ek vector hai 2i, 2i plus 3j. Aap isko aise likh sakte ho ya aap isko aise likh sakte ho. Usually we don't write it as 2i or 3j, theek hai? Lekin yahan pe space kam rahi to maine aapko show karwane ke liye upar diya. Either you write it like this or you write like this. दोनों में से कोई एक करता है, उनको mix नहीं करते, ऐसे नहीं लिखते. Alright, so when you are doing column vectors, ये i j नहीं लिखेगा. लेकिन जब आप वैसे लिख रहे हो तो आप 2.5i plus 6j को सारा उसने सॉल्व किया, ठीक है? सो इट्स योर चॉइस हाउ यू वांट टू राइट इट. नेक्स्ट इट्स सेइंग अ पार्टिकल बी ट्रेवल्स विद द वेलोसिटी दिस, फाइंड द स्पीड. सो बी की स्पीड चाहिए और हमें वेक्टर पता है, सो वी बी का मैग्नीट्यूड चाहिए हमें. तो दैट्स गोइंग टू बी 12 स्क्वायर्ड प्लस 9 स्क्वायर्ड square root, so that's going to be 144 plus 81, that is, I don't know, 5 square root 225, which is 50. So VB, velocity of B is 12 and velocity of A is that thing. All right. Okay, the next part isn't really in our syllabus, so we'll just leave that one out. Although it's really easy, लेकिन अभी हमें करने की ज़रूरत नहीं. Okay, let's move on to 2020 onwards, the topic on relative velocity was taken out of the syllabus. So अब हमारे पास ये है. जब भी आप past years करेंगे, you will encounter questions on relative velocity matrices. Remember that they are both not in the syllabus anymore. Also sets. Okay, this doesn't have any question on it. Let's do this. So, ye vectors ka question hai samne. Let's see. The diagram shows the three topics not in the syllabus are relative velocity matrices and sets. So, you shouldn't practice the questions from those when you're doing previous past years. Like, 2019 और onwards जो भी पुराने past years हैं उनमें ये हैं, so इन questions को आप छोड़ दीजिएगा. Alright, let's do this. The diagram shows a triangle OAB such that O is A and OB is B. ठीक है, position vectors मिल गया हमें. The point P lies on OA as the diagram shows such that OP is 3/4 OA. So basically this thing is 3/4 of this thing. So if 3 and 4 ratio, ENT ratio. Again, this is not the magnitude, this is the ratio. The point Q is the midpoint of AB. So AB ka midpoint hai. So matlab ye hissa aur ye hissa ek jaisa hai. The lines O, B and PQ are extended to meet the point R. Theek hai, find the middle of AB, AB. And AB kya hoga? AB is going to be OB minus OA, as we know. So it's going to be B vector minus A vector. PQ. Okay, so first we have to find P and then we have to find Q. So, agar hum isko dekhen, to hum keh sakte hain ki OP is 3/4 OA, to iska matlab hai ki wo ban jayega 3/4 A vector. Similarly, OQ hume nahi pata, lekin hume ye pata hai ki AQ is 1/2 AB because it's a midpoint, right? So I can say that is 1/2 B minus A. Okay. So mere paas AQ bhi hai, mere paas OP bhi hai. To mujhe PQ chahiye. To PQ agar mujhe chahiye, to main ye kehta hu ki PQ is you go from P to A and then A to Q. Right? You can do that. Ab P to A kaise jayenge aap? P to A will be OA minus OP and AQ we already have plus AQ. So my bus OA is A, OP is 3/4 A plus AQ. AQ is half B minus A. So half B minus half A. That's AQ. So you just simplify this. This becomes 1/4 A minus half A. So minus 1/4 A. Plus half B, and that's our final answer. Okay. Any question?
No, sir.
All right. It is given that NPQ is equal to QR and BR is KB, where N and K are positive constants. find QR in terms of N, A, and P. Q हमारे पास है, वो diagram आपके जहन में से, ये Q है, वो R है. Q से अगर आपने R तक जाना है, so there may be multiple ways of doing that. N use कर रहे हैं, हम PQ को use कर रहे हैं, ठीक है. और BR नहीं use करना, मतलब K को use नहीं करना. So QR को अगर हम use करें, तो we know it is NPQ. And PQ we have already found, I think. So it is going to be n times this. So that is minus 1 by 4 n a plus half n b. Find qr in terms of k, a, and b. Qr ko humne br ko use karna hai. Wo keh raha hai ki br ko use karenge to q aayega na. So qr ke liye main keh sakta hu q se b chale jaye aur b se r chale jaye, right? This path. So this is the direct path, that is the indirect path. So I can say that QR equals to Q to B plus B to R. Now Q to B is half of AB because we already know it's halfway there. Na? So half of AB, nikal lete hain. AB hamare paas ye hai. So 1 by 2 AB plus BR. 1 by 2 AB is B minus A. BR is KB. Simplify कर लेंगे, will become half plus k b minus half a, and that's our answer. अब वो कह रहे हैं कि find the value of n and k, और इसके लिए हमें देखना है कि देखें qr qr है, चाहे वो आप किस मर्जी पाथ से जाएं. So एक उसकी value ये है, एक उसकी value ये है. So we'll just equate them. We'll say okay, it's going to be minus 1 by 4 n a plus half n b. Sorry, n is not a vector. Equals half plus KB minus half A. So I'll know that A portion, this whole thing, I can equate it to A over here. Or B ka ye sara kuch yahan pe hai, I can equate it to B ka ye sara kuch yahan. So if I do that, from the first one, I get then minus 1 by 4 N is equal to minus 1 by 2. So minus minus, it cancel ho gaya. N is going to be plus 2. So that I know for N now. I'll plug it in the second one, half n is equal to half plus k. So half n is basically half into 2 equals to half plus k, which again is going to be 2, 2 se cancel, okay, k is equal to half. So I found k, I found n, and we are done here.
Minus 1 over 2. Sir,
minus ho gaya.
1 minus half is half.
Sir, 1 over 2 times 2 ho jata hai 1, and then you take 1 yes. over 2 on that side. So it's minus yes, 1 over 2.
It will become 1 minus half. Achha, to mein likh deta hun. Again, 1 over 2 times 2 is 1.
Okay, theek hai.
Aur wo half idhar aa jayega, aur hamare paas ye final answer hai. I'm sorry, I try to do these things in my head. Theek hai. So that's this question. Let's move on to the next one. Seth, usually classes are 1 hour long, but if the paper gets done earlier and we don't have any other problems, so we let it be for that day. Okay, this paper maybe nahi hai aisa koi vectors ka question. So I'm going to share some questions with you on vectors from older papers. So I would suggest you use the remaining time that you have to go through those. And if you have any problems, I'm here.